obviously with all of sports being shut down essentially, the American Hockey League was affected as well. I think it was a couple hours after the NHL said that they were shutting down the season, the American Hockey League followed suit. And we still had 12 games left in the regular season. We had 6 home games left, but the goals organization acted so quick on letting us know that they were still going to be paying us for the 4 games left in March. And then last Friday was the final game in March, and they let us know that they were going to be paying us for the 2 games missed in April as well. With the Padres, it really does come down to the fans being in the ballpark. So that's without kids and adults spending money around the ballpark, it's kind of it wouldn't be necessary for us to be there. Especially we have 10 to 15 people working each shift, depending on how busy it is. If it's a weekend Dodgers game or a weekday game against the Marlins, different shift levels, but it'll be interesting to see if the MLB does go the route of not allowing fans in the stadium, because that would put a damper on us. But also, MLB's also talked about having neutral site games for teams. So say, the Colorado Rockies and the Diamondbacks can't play in either of their stadiums, they might play in San Diego. So it'd be interesting to see if we have any effect on working those games if there are extra home games at Petco Park that aren't Padres related. But also I could see fans being a little tentative about coming to a ballpark where there's 20, 30, 40,000 people shortly after this, even if fans are allowed. With COVID-19 sort of putting a halt to sports right now, there's no Padres games for us to work. So as of now, there's nothing, but even if there are games that don't have fans in them, I'll still be busy working for Fox Sports, which is a sigh of relief for me with having the Padres job as well. Something that does have me nervous, however, is if the MLB does go the route of having double headers, because that could create long days for me where I'm either working 2 games at Fox Sports or 2 games at the Padres, depending on different staff levels. Before the season started, I had mapped out a schedule for my March and April games where I was going to be working 12 of the 16 Padres games, where I was going to be working Fox Sports before and then heading over to the ballpark and working those games. So obviously financially it's taken a toll on me during this month. But it's nice knowing that as long as baseball does get underway at some point, that Fox Sports will be there, and I'll be able to still be able to produce content over there for them. I mean, with my goals job, I'd be right back in the arena, whether there's fans or not, for those last few games if they do replay them. The goals did say that if those 6 games that we missed are replayed and we've already are getting paid for them, that they would pay us again for the games that we actually do work as well, which was a really nice move of them. And with the Padres, obviously we're still waiting on there's a $1 million relief fund that each of the teams are pledging towards their employees and part-time workers. So we're still waiting on details on how exactly all that's going to be paid out. The way that they're handling the situation is, all the teams work together as a collective unit there with the MLB. And so it's not a rush on figuring out when, because I know that they're good for their word. Obviously, it's a, multi-billion-dollar industry, and they're going to take care of their employees rather than having to worry about retraining people and, rehiring, going through orientations again. So they're taking care of their employees the best that they can. But who knows, the sports world in general is just, in times of distress, usually we all come towards sports. And right now we're in a time of distress, and it's weird to not have that break from reality and get to sports. So, and that's, for me as an employee of sports, it's tough, but also for just common people too, where they go to, they want to watch the Laker game at night, they want to watch the Giants game that day. Like, it's just background noise even. Like, it's kind of tough on all that.